Our next unit will be covering gases. And before we get into the specific properties and characteristics of gases, let's talk about the properties of gases versus liquids versus solids, as our next couple units are going to cover liquids and solids as well. So in terms of where we look at properties of a gas, the particles are very far apart, whereas in a liquid, our particles are typically touching, and in a solid, our particles are closely packed. And the way these particles interact with each other is going to be very, very different between a gas and a liquid and a solid. So we can dig a little bit deeper into how these particle interactions are going to influence the properties of the gas, the liquid, and the solid. In addition to having their particles really far apart, in a gas, these particles are very compressible. In a liquid, we can slightly compress the particles. And in a solid, these are not readily compressible. This is going to lead into what happens with the shape or volume. In a gas, we have no definite shape or volume. In a liquid, we have a definite volume, but no definite shape. And in a solid, we have a definite shape and volume. So again, these different characteristics are going to help us, you know, investigate different properties. So for now, we're going to focus on gases, and we'll come back to liquids and solids a little bit later. But we can look at these differences here and talk about some characteristics of the gases. So gases take on the shape of their container and completely fill it. And the volume of the gas is going to equal the volume of the container. And this volume will be dependent upon the pressure and the temperature. Another characteristic we're going to investigate is that both the pressure and volume depend on the temperature of a gas. The temperature of the gas is going to indicate how fast these gas particles are moving, and the pressure and the volume are going to be very dependent upon that. Another thing to note is that when you're doing calculations on gases, you must remember to keep all your temperature units in Kelvin. Another property of gases that we want to look at is that all gases are miscible, meaning that they're going to mix completely, forming homogeneous mixtures. And we're going to investigate a lot of the properties and characteristics of these mixtures as we go on through the chapter. Now, as we look at these characteristics of gases, in the next section that we're going to look at, we're going to look at something called pressure, which is how hard these gas particles hit the walls of the container that they're enclosed in. So the next video, we're going to address pressure and how we're going to use pressure to do various calculations and explain a lot of the properties of gases.